I know there are a lot of people who want to learn the basics of life insurance so that they can make more informed choices. So in this video, I'm going to cover the very basic foundation of an insurance policy, the transferring of risk from one person to an insurance company. And in the next video, I'm going to explain the differences between term, whole life, and universal life. But we need to get this groundwork covered for those who are starting from scratch. I'm going to explain risk transfer using a fictitious story. Don't get too caught up on the numbers. And we'll start our little story by going back a few hundred years. Let's say that there's this rich guy named Larry. And he was often found in the local pub drinking whiskey and just generally living his best life. Now, Larry was always looking for ways to make even more money. And everyone in town knew of Larry's wealth, and they would come up to him all the time in the pub and ask him for his money for loans, for investments in ideas for businesses, or what have you. And sometimes Larry would say yes, and sometimes he would say no. And one day, a farmer came to Larry and said, "Listen, I've got a problem. It's July, and my crops are due to be harvested in August. We've had a fantastic year this year, and we will earn more selling this year's crops than for the last 5 years combined. It'll be worth 100 gold coins." And Larry said, "You know, that hardly sounds like a problem, friend." "Well," continued the farmer, "hear me out. I'm the only one in the household who can harvest those crops. Without me, the crops will sit and die and become worthless. I know that once I harvest those crops, I can stop working for life. But I'm close to 40 years old," which was really old back then, "and I would like to make sure that no matter what happens to me, my family will be taken care of, even if it costs me money for that peace of mind." And so Larry thought for a moment, and then he said to the farmer, "Okay, here's what I can offer you. I want you to give me 20 gold coins right now. And if you die in a month's time before the harvest has been gathered, I will give your family 100 gold coins. Of course, if you don't die, I get to keep all your 20 gold coins. What do you say to that?" Larry had done some fast thinking before he made this offer to the farmer. And this farmer appeared to him to be in exceptionally good health for a 40-year-old. And Larry knew that for every 100 40-year-old men in town, on average, 5 would die in the next month. Larry was willing to bet that this farmer wouldn't be one of them. The farmer agreed to the scheme, and he survived to harvest and sell his last crop. He retired wealthy, so the story has a happy ending. And Larry was happy too. He had 20 gold coins that he did not have before making this bet on the farmer's life. So now let's take a look at the math. There were two possible outcomes. The farmer could have died before the harvest was completed, or he could have lived. And if the farmer died, remember that Larry had collected 20 gold coins up front. So if he paid out 100, he would really only be out 80 gold coins. If the farmer lived, then Larry keeps the 20 gold coins and doesn't have to pay out the 100 gold coins. So he would be up 20 gold coins. And remember, Larry estimated that for every 100 guys like the farmer, about 5 would die in the next month. From Larry's point of view, there was a 5% chance he would lose 80 gold coins versus a 95% chance that he would make 20 gold coins. Now, because Larry was very wealthy, he was able to come up with the 80 gold coins in case he lost his bet, so he decided to take on this risk. If we look at things from the farmer's perspective, let's consider four scenarios. What would happen if he died versus if he lived? And for each of those cases, with or without this insurance provided by Larry, if he lived, he would be able to sell his harvest for 100 gold coins. If he died, he would have no income from the harvest. If he had no insurance, he would not have paid the 20 gold coins to Larry, but if he did buy the insurance, he would have paid 20 gold coins to Larry. And if he died with the insurance in place, his family would have collected 100 gold coins from Larry. What this means is that in three scenarios, the farmer's family would have been able to maintain the farm and their lifestyle, and in one scenario, the family would have become homeless. Of course, this would be financially and emotionally catastrophic, and so the farmer was willing to pay for the peace of mind knowing that no matter what happened, his family would be taken care of. Okay, so obviously that's the whole premise behind insurance, paying some money to protect against catastrophic outcomes. And by the way, the cost of a policy is known as the premium. It's a fancy sounding word, but it just means the cost or the price that you pay for the coverage. It's called the premium. Let's now fast forward 10 years. Larry's scheme has caught on like wildfire, and a lot of people are coming up to him asking him questions. If 20 40-year-old men bought policies and they all had the same 5% chance of dying, that means that statistically one would die and 19 would live, which means that Larry would have to pay out one claim but collect premiums from all 20. If he charged them all 20 gold coins for the premium, that means that he would have collected 20 gold coins times 20 policies, which equals 400 gold coins. If he had only had to pay out one claim of 100 gold coins, he would expect an average profit of 300 gold coins every month. But a price of 20 gold coins for 100 gold coins in coverage was pretty expensive. So not too many people were that interested. But Larry knows that if he lowers the cost, he will attract more customers. So Larry starts to lower the premiums in order to attract more interest. A few years later, Larry now has a thriving business. Let's say he has 1,000 40-year-old men buying life insurance policies from him every single month. And again, he knows that they have a 5% chance of dying in that next month. That means that 50 of those 1,000 men will die, and he will have to pay out 50 times 100 gold coins, or 5,000 gold coins. If he just wanted to break even, that means he would need to generate 5,000 gold coins in premiums in total from all 1,000 men. That would make the cost, or the premiums, of these individual policies only 5 gold coins. But Larry also knows that sometimes more or less people die than what is statistically predicted. It's possible that some months only 40 men will die, while in other months maybe 60 men will die. Larry doesn't want to get caught out, nor does he want to run a nonprofit, so he sets the premiums at 7 gold coins. So every month he's collecting 7,000 gold coins and on average paying out 5,000. Again, on average, he's turning a profit of 2,000 gold coins per month. From his point of view, he's winning big time. But now let's take a look at the perspective of the insurance buyer. If they take out a policy for 7 gold coins, if they die and their families get 100 gold coins, they win. Of course, that's purely from a financial perspective. It's very morbid to think that you win when you die, but you collect on a life insurance policy. So when the premiums are low enough to get a lot of people interested in buying a policy, the risk can be spread out over a very large group. In this case, Larry is acting as the intermediary, facilitating the transfer of risk from many individuals to across a large group. And he's rewarded handsomely for doing that. Now you have a cursory understanding of risk transfer. And now we're ready to define terms like term life, whole life, and universal life insurance and other terms, which we'll do in the next video. I appreciate you hitting the like button on this video, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications for future videos, especially next week's video. Thanks so much for watching.